All right, welcome to Courtesy Flush. How you guys doing out there tonight?
Hello.
Hello. We were just talking about the dog making faces and stuff. Detective turns Mecha out, in space.
Yes, it is in space. It turns out if I talk low enough, the mic picks up, but you can't really hear it. So it just goes, mack, 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 mack.
Yeah, and now I'm an owl, so I gotta do all that now.
Ooh.
Yeah, but that's okay. We've got the Doot machine.
You know, in a weird way,
it's right over here, the Doot machine.
Mike, I've just realized the actual irony of you being an owl.
What? Why?
Owls and crows are basically mortal enemies.
Ah, okay. I see what you're
saying. They hate each other. Okay. They will actually go out of their way to attack one another because owls will attack crows when they're nesting at night and crows will attack owls when they're nesting in the day. It is like full on like gang violence in some
areas.
Yeah,
Square's like, Mike's face rig is a hoot. Hold on. I don't have an audience for that, do I? No.
I don't know.
I don't. I normally have like a bunch of like random sound effects, but not on this one. That's on the WBPL 76 one. I've got a bunch of stuff set up for
that. Makes sense.
Anyway,
that makes sense.
Let's get into the game, hopefully.
Yeah.
Let's see if it actually loads. Look, it loaded, didn't it?
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Oh my gosh. We've actually got a game and it's loaded.
Ah, there it goes. Load.
Yeah, there you go. Full on. This is a pretty
game.
I have
one.
To say the UI for this game is pretty intense because I remember the Windows 95 and it's like whoever made this was like, oh, we got to make it look even better.
What were we doing?
We were searching for clues.
Get started at the office.
These are
mailing.
These are hints.
Whoa, we didn't even look at these last time.
Now, if you click on a hint, it'll give you take points away from you.
Oh, okay. We'll come back to these later. If we need them, though, that's actually really in-depth hints. I like that.
All right.
Ah, the once majestic Chandler Avenue. There's enough radiation in this asphalt to fry.
Yeah. You've heard that. Now, we gotta go... Oh, no. We gotta go talk to, Here. Yeah.
Yeah, Louis.
Louis!
Louis Lemaitre runs the
really
Brew and
wholesome.
Stew, which is a local hangout.
Yeah, we need chocolate syrup, right?
Yeah, we gotta get some chocolate syrup. Okay. Wait, no.
Yep.
What? But, there we go.
What can I get you?
We need to talk. Ask about...
Everybody. Let's do this.
But also chocolate syrup. We'll start at the top and go down.
Rook's an ornery old cuss, but me and him are old buddies. We fought in the big war together. He's one person you can trust in these troubled times.
Okay, good to know. Tell me about Chelsea.
Chelsea acts tough, but she has to be with all the scum around. And she's as smart as she is pretty. She knows a lot of what goes on in the shadows of this city.
So, Ben, we have to get chocolate syrup to give to a chocolate syrup addict so we can get info on a robbery. Hello!
Hello. Hey, man.
Yeah, things are a little slow, but I'm getting by.
Having
to lay off some of my kitchen help hurt my pride more than anything.
Aw, that's always a tough call to make.
Granny's a fireball. She and Sal opened the pizza place 7 to 8 years ago, and they've been fighting ever since.
Sal Lucido.
Yes, Sal Lucido. We'll have to go to the pizza place later.
Sal's a big guy with an appetite for food, wine, and women. He comes by here most every day for lunch.
Okay.
Ardo Newpop.
That's the name. I like it.
Ardo comes in now and again. Usually orders a couple of steaks and a chocolate milk.
Ah.
His temp is as short as he is tall. And he's only got one oar in the water. A bad combination.
So
okay.
A very big, tall guy who comes in and just says, like, steak, chocolate, milk.
And chocolate milk. That is... like I said, that is a combination.
Sorry, Mife. Can't help you there.
All right, tell me about Rusty Clown.
He was a strange one. He had a show on TV for a while. Got pretty popular. Then he quit the show and went into business. He opened up a shop right up the street from here.
Rusty?
I guess he wasn't a very good businessman. The shop went out of business within a couple of months. Then Rusty just disappeared. I heard he'd made some enemies in the novelty trade.
The novelty trade. That's a tough racket, I guess.
That's a tough racket, the novelty trade.
It is. Mm.
Rook told me about the bracelet, but I don't know anything more about it.
Tell me about the burglary.
Rook's been robbed before, but he's never had anything really valuable taken. This is gonna set Rook back for a while. Too bad the cops have turned a blind eye.
Yeah, it sounds like they're dirty around here.
Yeah.
You want to try a slice of my chocolate pie? I can get you a piece to go if you like.
There you go. You got yourself a piece of chocolate pie. Can we examine that, please? Could you hit the examine button?
We're going to examine that.
Wow. Look at
that chocolate pie. That actually does look kind of good.
That is a really...
I mean, I've never seen a chocolate pie in two layers like that. So it looks more like a cake with a pie crust, but at the same time, chocolate pie is tasty. We have chocolate. We have something chocolate to give the guy.
MadAc83, thanks for stopping by.
Ever
thanks for the courtesy.
Since the crusade started
thank you.
The relations between norms and mutants has gone to pot. I've had rocks thrown through my windows. Graffiti sprayed on the bricks outside. There's not much I can do, though.
That's just rude. He seems like such a chill dude. Why would you... Why? He's just running a diner.
I have
Is that
no
it?
Idea, man.
Okay, looks like that's it.
Hey, how's it going, Diggs?
Well, hello. Well, we have pie to go give the man in the alley. How do we get back to the, It's this way. Yeah, right over here. All right.
I've got the SC-55 or 88 back there with my keyboard hooked into it and the game, so.
Haha.
This isn't a good time for a social call, punk.
If I don't get a fix soon, I'll go insane. Dory, me, Fossil, a lot to do.
Oh, gosh. Oh, and
don't
doesn't...
worry.
Oh, no, no. You...
I've got the thing for
in the
you.
Later games, Nick. In the later games.
Can I give it? How do I give it to him? Make an offer.
I don't make a practice of helping out addicts, but I think I've got something that will ease the pain.
Take this pie.
Oh, hold out on me, man. If you've got something, let's have it.
Give him the pie. Offer from inventory. Chocolate pie. And,
Yeah, I guess it offer.
Praise heaven! You brought the ambrosia of life. Ask me anything you want.
That's a man who likes chocolate.
There we go. We have chocolate.
Yes, the chocolate man.
Ah, yes, the chocolate man.
Ah, okay. We'll start from the top.
Yeah.
Rook,
he leaves me alone. Can't ask for more than that.
That's fair. Chelsea.
I think Chelsea used to fancy me. Till she found out my only true love was chocolate. Damn near broke her heart.
I'm sure it did, sir. I'm sure it did.
Nice guy. Good cook. Every National Feed a Bum Day, he brings me one of his award-winning chocolate pies.
Ugh. Feed a Bum Day? Feed a Bum Day?
Feed a Bum
Truly day. Dystopian future.
Yep.
The 2047, actually. This is 2047.
It's like, 24 years into the future.
24 years in the future, New San Francisco.
I don't have much to do with her. They don't serve anything with chocolate in it at the pizza joint.
But pizza. Pizza, man.
The only time I ever see Sal is when he gets drunk and comes by to pick a fight. Then I kick his butt and send him on his way.
I feel like Sal's going to have a different story answer for that.
Ardo.
That big goon. He used to hassle me until I shared a quart of chocolate syrup with him. Now he lets me alone.
That's good.
Okay. All right. The Colonel.
Wish I could help.
Rest down.
Excuse me. Don't know a thing about it.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Zoom tight.
Yeah.
Sorry. Bah. Can't help you with that.
Tell me about the burglary.
I saw someone prowling around the back of the pawn shop last night. It was so dark, I didn't get a good look at him, but I could tell he was huge. Probably 6'3 or 6'4, about 300 pounds.
Who stole his eye? Can you return
it? I don't know.
That's true.
If we probably will.
Yeah. I think if you had the option.
I stay out of politics, especially bad politics.
Talking about the crusade that's going on
against
mutants.
That is wise words. Yeah.
Mac Mulder.
This man's just here for one thing and one thing only, and that's chocolate. He doesn't want to do with politics.
Wish I could help.
I don't even know who that is.
I don't remember. Right. But yeah, there you go.
Me
you
either.
Talk to the chocolate guy.
All right, we got the chocolate guy figured out. Wait, I just want to see how's he sit. Okay, he's just floating in there.
Hey, you know, he's waist deep in. Thigh deep in, I should say.
Whoa, okay. Whoa. All right,
Mac, you need to lay off the chocolate.
I hadn't had any chocolate. I just had tea.
I just had some tea. Why are you fine?
Oh, you shush you. All right, let's see. We got Louise.
Yeah, oh, Ralphie just says Mac Mulden is a police guy.
Okay. See, this is...
Pizza bar.
Oh, the pizza place. Is it open? Well, hello? You open?
We'll open the door. Let's see.
Francesca Lucido makes the spiciest pizza in the city. The only thing spicier than her cooking is her imagination. And right now, she seems to have a thing for me.
Oh.
Oh, no.
Well, it's that a handsome PI Tex Murphy. Have you come
the
to take
accent.
Me away?
You come to take her away?
No, I haven't. You're a married woman, apparently. I'm not. No, we ain't doing that. But, let's see.
Just.
I feel like the humor would probably be the best way. Otherwise, she's probably going to slap me.
How'd you guess? You must have seen my white horse hitched to the railing out front.
Please tell me she gets the sarcasm.
Oh my, Mr. Murphy, you certainly know how to excite a girl.
Oh gosh. Oh no. No, we're not doing that. Nope.
That's the option. Shatter the fantasy of a lonely woman. Why? That's such a great name.
I have to pick it just because of how horrible it is. The naming conventions of these options are so much better than some. Right.
Okay. Look, I was only joking. I came by to ask you some questions.
Oh, poo. All business and no pleasure makes even a private dick a dull boy. What do you want?
Yeah, let's ask her about everything.
Okay, all right. Start at the top.
Rook is a tough old geezer. I've known him ever since we opened the Slice of Heaven back in 32, but I can't say I know him very well.
Chelsea. Mm.
Chelsea is a nicer girl. Sal tries to flirt with her, but she doesn't give him the time of day.
Louis.
What is her accent? I'm trying to decide. What is...
Mayday. Hey, Epic. Yeah, take care out there in the skies.
Oh. Yeah.
I like Louis. He runs a nicer place, and I go over there and chat with him when the business is slow.
Oh.
Right. I'm glad she's like, that's nice.
Well, I was hoping you'd get around to asking about me. I'm just a lonely, hot-blooded woman who needs the love of a good, strong man.
Oh, she's thirsty.
Wow.
She has the thirst.
Oh, man. She is ready.
Giggle, you're right. It sounds like Italian Jewish.
She's like...
Like someone's trying to do a tie-in.
She's like, I swipe right on everything. And she's like, and nobody comes by.
Oh, no.
It's probably...
Me and Sal got married too young, and it's been up and down ever since. I've had enough of his drinking and the womanizing, and I divorce him in a second. But he's got a couple of buddies who are top lawyers. If I had some hard evidence of his screwing around, I could divorce him and get a decent settlement.
Ah, okay. Yeah, no, I was going to say,
unhappy marriage.
She straight up just slights right on everybody, and they all stop by, and she's just like... It's the life I live.
That is...
It's a pizza shop, man.
There's a thirst and willing to guzzle salt water. Oh my god. That's certainly a way to put it.
Arda is an overgrown kid. He comes in here for the all-you-can-eat buffet, and I've got to kick him out every time. If I didn't, he'd eat everything we got.
Ardo.
Can't help you, Tex.
No.
Tell me about Rusty Clown.
He was a weirdo who opened up a shop just down the street. That would have been a couple of years ago. The business went under in a hurry and the clown just disappeared.
Okay.
Sorry, I don't know anything about that.
You know what?
Does she
you
have
know, I realized
on her apron?
Oh, I think so. Chili peppers or something.
Yeah.
I was going to say, you should probably ask the questions as if you're the detective, because you're just, she's like responding as if you're asking, but we're not hearing him say anything. So you
that
could
is
totally,
true.
You could totally phrase it however you want to, actually. That's kind of cool.
All right. What do you know about the burglary?
I heard that Rook's place got robbed. It scares me to death. There's so much crime in this part of the city.
Oh, yeah.
All right. What about the Crusade? He had any dealings with the Crusade recently?
That's that religion for norms only? It makes me sick.
I love her hand gestures.
The hand gestures on this woman are fantastic. Yeah. All right, tell me about Mac Malden.
Sorry. Ask me about something else.
Well, I ain't got nothing else, so,
bye.
Goodbye.
Run.
Yeah, no, we flee. That's a thirsty woman. I do not want a part of it. All right, so we get there. That's the pawn shop. Okay, whoa. Okay, I guess let's go talk to Chelsea. I don't think we've talked to her since we found out about the robbery. Let's see if she knows anything. Hey, Chelsea.
Hi, Tex. How's the investigation going? Is there anything I can do to help?
Okay, let's see. You got anything on, let's see.
Well, let's see. You've not asked her about, the bracelet.
No, I haven't.
So everything bracelet down you have not asked, yeah.
All right. So have you heard about this bracelet from Rooks?
Sorry, I haven't heard anything about that.
Oh.
All right, thanks, Clarissa Knows It All. That's who she looks like. So Clarissa Knows It All.
She
does
have
show.
Clarissa Explains It All shirt and hat
explains
on.
Explains It All. That's not Knows It All, but yeah.
Na, 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 na. Yeah, I remember that. That was great.
I remember that show. It was pretty good. I don't remember a lot, but I remember it.
Yeah, she's definitely got the, you know, Melissa Joan Hart look going on. I dig it.
So have you heard about the burglary down the street? It's literally right next to you.
Yeah, you know, I remember Rook told me about the burglary.
That just
you
happened.
Know, I remember a stranger hanging around the past couple of days. It might be a dead end, but I seem to remember that the guy had these bright green eyes and a tattoo of an anchor on his arm.
That's more relief than I got any other time.
Well, that's good to know.
Bright green eyes and an anchor on his arm. All right.
Gotta be writing that down.
Let's see. I need a notepad.
Notepad activate.
Gotta get a piece of paper. Notepad. Got a notepad. All right. Hold on. Let's get got my detective paper here.
Yeah, exactly.
And a pen. We're good to go. gotta add in the sound effects. I'm sorry. All right. So, suspect. Write this in orange Sharpie.
Suspect.
Bright green eyes. Anchor tattoo on arm. All right.
Yeah. All right.
Also,
Carl looks like he's ready
this...
to deal with the issue.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, 100%. All right, so what do you know about this crusade? You got any dealings with the religious...
The crusade is big. I mean, much bigger than most people know. They have operatives all over... And then these huge sections of the norm population are joining. Well, they say it's a religion, but then they encourage the members to be violent and prejudiced towards others.
That's not very nice at all. Tell me about Mac Malden. What do you know about him?
Wish I could help you there, Tex.
Mm-hmm. All right, all right.
Yeah.
So, the Crusades, not really religion per se. It's just a bunch of people being bigoted and stuff. And then bright green eyes and tattoo of an anchor. All right, let's see. Thank you, Chelsea. Let's roll on down here. Let's see. Now this is Rusty's place.
It's all locked up. The only way I'm gonna get inside is by using my innate cleverness or ingenuity, or maybe a key.
Okay, we'll have to get a key for that later. I feel like we're going to have to get in there. Look at that guy's face. Hold on, just look at that guy's face. Look at this. Look at this clown. Look at those pixels. That is...
That's
why do you have
horrifying.
That hat?
Yeah.
I know. Why three, like,
well,
three
why don't you look at it?
Gesture things? So we can get good... Whoa.
Rusty the Clown's Novelty Shop. Closed down a few months ago after Rusty mysteriously disappeared. The police suspect foul play, but I think he probably just choked to death on his own bad jokes.
Yikes.
Okay. He must have been a bad clown.
These graphics are pretty good for the time of release. Yeah, it's considering how this was state of the art back then. The voice acting, I think there was like a floppy disk version, I want to say. I don't know for sure.
Floppy disk?
Yeah,
nice.
I don't know. I don't know if there was, because I know this came on like four CDs.
Acme Warehouse.
Oh, wow. Take a look at that.
Wile E. Coyote.
Looks like someone's locked the door.
Take a look at the warehouse.
The Acme Warehouse is the former Snow White dry cleaning building. Nobody's used this place in a while. Looks like someone's locked the door.
Boo.
Disc.
We'll
comma,
have to get... Let's see. How do you look up again? It's,
Daniel.
How? Whoa.
You got these, like, quick actions, it looks like.
Okay, so how do I look up?
I believe that is up. Arrow key up, yep.
Arrow key up, okay. Yep. All right.
The Acme Warehouse is the former Snow...
All right. Let's go down this way. Let's see, we got the looks like a vending machine and then through the gate. Let's check out this place. The Golden Gate Hotel.
The Golden Gate Hotel was once known as the Waldorf of the Pacific. Its halls are still sturdy and the walls have worn well. But there's nobody living inside.
Okay. That was beautiful.
That's great.
That is amazing.
I love this game.
Oh, let's go. Inside. Ha-ha.
Ardo Newpop is a gigantic goon who works at the front desk at the Golden Gate Motel. Ardo's no rocket scientist. In fact, he probably doesn't even know what a rocket scientist is.
Oh, okay. Is that him? Okay, Bruscapoach.
Boob tube hobnobbing,
or standard detective introduction.
Well, considering he's watching TV.
That.
Anything good on the tube today?
Uh-huh. I'm watching the Captain Wallaby show, and he's so funny.
Why don't we see him?
Oh, no.
Rude. Show some interest. Disagree. Let's show some interest.
Captain Wallaby, your favorite show?
It's my third favorite show. My favorite
is
the
man.
Inspector Burns Fire Safety Show.
Inspector Burns Fire Safety Show.
Oh, yeah.
Make conversation or name-dropping fib. I don't want to do disagreeable. I feel like this guy's not going to be easy to deal with.
It looks like he could pick Tex up and throw him across the room. I mean, look how big
really,
he is.
It really does. That is a very tall man. That's a very tall man.
It's a big boy.
Why is that
not
your
this
favorite
angle,
show?
Because
fire safety is very important, and I want to grow up to be just like Inspector Burns.
Oh.
Ooh, this, none of the...
Pick which one
like
you
want to
do, Mecha.
We're just going to go,
Don't do whatever you feel. Use your detective instinct.
B.
Well, I'm sure Inspector Burns would be thrilled. Can I ask you some questions?
Okay, that's pretty harmless.
Okay. I can answer some questions, but first I have to put on my fire hat because Inspector Burns' fire safety show is going to be on pretty soon.
Okay.
That's fine, buddy. You wear whatever hat you want to wear. All right.
He's got more growing to do. Oh, no.
Oh my gosh. My heart actually goes out to this guy. It's like, you, sir. Oh, no.
Yeah.
Yeah.
His dedication to his fandom is commendable.
I went to his pawn shop because I thought he would have Inspector Burns action figures, but he didn't. And I got mad at him, so he probably don't like me.
Oh.
Aw, okay. Okay.
Ooh, Chelsea is pretty cool, because she's got good magazines and stuff. That's where I bought my Inspector Burns fire safety manual.
Oh. Good to know. Good to know. All right.
So he's got some opinions, yeah.
All right. Oh, I skipped one by accident.
She's the lady who makes the best pizza. I eat at her pizza place all the time because I love it.
That's fair. Tell me about Louie.
He's a nice guy and I like to eat there because there's a TV.
Okay, he likes the TV. That's good.
I don't know what that is.
So he doesn't deal with Sal. Probably good. Tell me about yourself.
I just want to be like my hero, Inspector Burns, because fire safety is very important.
Yeah, he's right. Fire safety is super important.
It is important.
Thanks, Ardo.
Honestly, Zilson, I agree with you. They define, I got mad at him. I'm concerned. That is, like, how mad? Did you just yell at him, or did you, like, have a tantrum kind of mad? These are two very different kind of mad.
Well, considering how Rook is, like, really snide at the time, Ardo probably almost threw him through the window.
Probably.
I never heard nothing about that.
That's fine. I don't think you know the Colonel anyway, but do you know Rusty the Clown?
I used to watch his TV show, and it was pretty good, but then it stopped. And then he opened a store down the street, and I used to go there and buy stuff, but then it closed.
That's pretty accurate, yeah.
Yeah.
This is painful. I wonder if the devs had low...
I don't know about that.
I don't know, but...
I can agree that the man in his position should appreciate fire safety.
I agree with that.
Yeah.
Well, did you hear anything about the bracelet? A bracelet while you were talking to Rook?
I don't know what that is.
That's fair. Did you hear about the burglary at Rook's? That's like a pretty big deal.
I never heard nothing about that.
To be fair, it did just happen like last night, so it's fine. Did you hear about that crusade? They haven't been bothering you. Oh, no, I hope they haven't been bothering you. That could end badly.
I heard about that, but I don't know what a crusade is.
Good. Stay away from them. I think that would be a bad influence for you. Inspector Burns wouldn't like that. Do you know about Mac Malden, though?
I don't know what that is.
Okay.
Well, he's answered your questions, and it seems like it is time to leave.
Well, I'll let you get back to Inspector Burns' fire safety.
Good. All right.
Let's see.
Oh, all right, we're out of that.
We could have
just smushed you.
He seems like a pretty pleasant fellow, though.
Oh, yeah,
like,
absolutely.
Like a pleasant fellow.
What's this?
I don't know, but we're going that way.
Tower up there? All right.
We are headed towards this tower because there's a hole in the fence and we can walk through it. Plus, it looks like there's a hot dog stand over here.
Coit Tower was once a majestic landmark. The wiener stand on the patio at the base of Coit Tower made the best chili dog in town.
Ooh.
No one's here right now, though, so I better check back later.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, at least that tells me to come back later. All right, so... Well... Oh, wait, can we go back here? Or is that just a corner? That's just a corner. Okay.
I know.
That's closed. Now...
More gold, your majesty!
Wow,
oh, hey,
more
Ether,
gold.
Hey. Thanks
now,
for... Hey, nice. Well,
Blaine,
Ether,
what
going?
Is this? Hello.
Looks like someone took a pee here.
Well,
alright, that's,
Yeah,
I'm not going to mess with that then. So, if I interact with a car, can I go anywhere?
Maybe.
My trusty 31 Lightning Bolt Speeder. I still regret not getting the sunroof option.
Ooh. Whoa, we can. Okay, we can go the police station. Let's go to the police station. Look at that guy. We're going there. I want to talk to that guy. He's also got a hat. Whoa.
I haven't seen Mac Malden since the Martian Memorandum case. I remember him as a surly, incompetent, fat-nosed cop. As I step into his office, I can see he's changed. His nose is even bigger.
Okay.
Well, if it isn't Tex Murphy. I figured you'd be dead by now.
You could tell that this was made in the 80s, early 90s, because he's smoking it.
Yeah.
Let's give a... You know what? I'm feeling spicy. Let's give a faux compliment.
Good to see you too, Mac. You look great. That extra weight sure suits you.
Still the wise guy, eh, Murphy? It was great to see you. Now get lost!
Nah.
Listen, I'm working on a burglary case, and I'm looking for a lead.
You and me both, Seamus. The mayor's office is all over me again. You heard about the string of pawn shop robberies? We have no suspects, and I'm catching the heat for it.
Pride which goeth before the fall, suck up, or shocked by an epitude. I feel like...
So you and your crack team of detectives have no leads?
Of course we have leads, you pots. We know he's a norm, Caucasian, and has AB negative blood.
Ooh, there you go.
That narrows down our list of suspects to about a million. Now get out of my hair. I got work to do.
That was really clever, Mecha. Nicely done. You just gave it...
So he was...
A norm, Caucasian.
Norm. Caucasian. And AB negative blood. How do they know his blood type already? Wait, if they've got his blood, they should have a DNA sample.
Yeah, but...
This was before DNA was a really big thing, though. Or using as frequently.
I guess. I'd also, you know... Do you really want to wait for the police to do it, or you want to go do it?
That's true. That's very true. I'm going to have to swap to something besides a Sharpie, because otherwise I'm going to bleed through the second page of my notes. All right, let's go back to our office.
Yes, office.
Oh, look at those comfy chairs. Office. By Chris Jones, Tex Murphy is the brother of the actor who plays Mac. That's cool.
Oh, wow. That's awesome.
That is cool. I bet he smokes it in bed. He should get that other dude to tell him about fire safety. Dialogue options have gone downhill since the 90s. They really have. All right. Let's see. Okay. Let's look at our inventory. What have we got? Surgery gift certificate, the credit card, flyer, stamp, pin, key from the alley. Wait a minute.
Key from the alley. Oh, you think it might go to that?
Wait. I gotta open the door first. Hold on. Huh? Let's go downstairs. Whoa. Downstairs. Whoa. Nope. Look at the stairs. No, look at the stairs. There we go. Now, forward we go. On very glidey tank treads. Let's run into this wall for a second. All right. Now, that place... I bet... That key is going to go here. Now, how can I use?
It's all locked up.
Wait. and then just click.
Well, that's not gonna work.
Ah, boo, it doesn't work with this one. Ooh, maybe.
Yeah.
The warehouse. Hmm. Wait. Gotta go over here. And, haha.
Are you gonna break and enter into this warehouse?
Well, that's not gonna work.
Ooh, not today. It goes somewhere else.
It does. What other buildings around here are locked? Ooh, maybe this one. You know, we haven't even looked at the theater.
Oh, and there's also a front door to your apartment complex.
Because
you go upstairs. You can just go through the front door.
You're right. Okay, let's check out the front door.
The Ritz Hotel.
Yeah.
So he rents out an apartment.
On the top floor of this place is where I hang my hat. It's not much, but it's better than... Well, it's not much.
I guess you can't go in there.
I can't actually open the door. Nope.
Yeah, that's at later games, I think, you can go in.
So let's... No, go this way. Nope. I'm stuck on the environment. Okay.
Yeah, this is a way grimmier than a real Countach cabin. Yeah.
The Bijou Theater used to be quite a night spot. It was condemned years ago and could collapse any day. There's no way I'm going in there.
Never mind. We can't go
Not
in there.
This will imply a game, but this looks like a padlock key, says Ether.
So, who's got a padlock that needs to be open?
And it's funny because this isn't a Sierra game. This is not a Sierra game at all. This is a Access software game.
No, we haven't even checked out the electronics shop with its want of...
You can't.
That I know, but look at that door. It's kind of cool.
Cyberpunk.
This is the brand new electronics shop outlet. No pun intended.
Mm.
I won't be
totally
able to
intended.
Get inside the electronics shop until I get a membership card.
I'm going to have to get a membership card just to get inside there, I think. So how do this work? Do I just go put it in the mail?
Well, you have to sign it.
Yeah.
You do have a pen.
Oh, wait. We do have a pen. All right. We're going to combine that and the pen.
All right.
Whoa.
And signed.
Aha.
You fill
out
an application.
Okay.
Don't forget to put a stamp on it.
Oh, you're right. We do have a stamp.
$10 stamp.
$10 stamp.
There you go. Now just put that.
Oh, yeah, that's totally out of it.
Put that in the mail. I'm sure no one will read your social security.
Not at all. No one's going to read my personal information as I walk over and put this unenveloped just out in the open. Application with a stamp stuck to it.
The postal service has gotten much faster since the stamp price went to $10. I should get my credit card back tomorrow morning.
That's actually way fast.
Okay.
They don't even worry about the processing. That's how quick credit cards can be done in the future.
Because that's the credit cards. Hey, Norm, you look like you got a lot of blood. What is that? AB negative? Who asks that?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly, Jake. Who said he was a sensible man?
No, you know, I actually didn't look at this thing over here. It looks kind of like a vending machine. Let's go. What are you? Or a newspaper machine.
I heard this newspaper box got destroyed right after Chelsea opened her newsstand. Coincidence?
never mind. Okay, all right. So, well, I know it takes away points, but I'm just kind of curious. What do we need? Let's try... We have to get a fax machine and using a crime link computer.
Yeah, you don't have to click on it. You can just go find out what to do.
Alright, let's go to the crime link computer in my office. And not get stuck on my car, thank you. Up the stairs.
Yeah, this
is... Oh, look at that pixely background. Boop.
And dance studio.
On the top floor of this place.
I do like that's a dance studio as well. Get...
Now you just walk through the door.
I know, but his door also just opened through.
Yeah.
Hold on, hold on, hold on. Hold on.
You're just having a dream, Mecha. Step through the door and everything will be okay. You're just having a dream.
The collision of this stuff is amazing. All right. Where's my computer? There it is. All right.
Crime-Link computer is the only valuable piece of equipment left in the office. By entering suspect information like height, weight, and hair color, I can access the suspect's personal files.
All right. And, okay. We also have the height of...
So it was registered to Alberto Smith.
3 or 4.
Oh, look, there's your options.
About 300 pounds.
Okay.
Oh, this pen's messy. Oh my gosh, why is this ink gooping all over the end of the pen? What in the world?
It is okay. A very subtle plate.
Caucasian male, 6'6", 4. That. No. Next. Nothing on the hair color, but 2 eyes, green, AB negative, shoe size, no idea.
Well, we can find out from behind the pawn shop, actually.
Ooh. Anchor on the arm. You're right, we can. Let's go do that.
That's an arm scar.
Oh, oops. Hold on. All right. I forgot about the shoe prints. Oh, gee. Hold on. Let me collect myself here.
Okay, you got this. Excuse me. You got this.
All right. And, haha. Gotta
open
the
door
to
the street.
Yep. I know it is. Open it. Thank you. I'm glad you opened it that way this time instead of out to the...
It's a double hinge door, you know, just in case.
That doesn't seem... You know what? It's fine. It's fine. This is the weird future of 27 years in the future. We're gonna fly in cars then, you know.
Afternoon. Hey, how's it going, Jake the Warlord?
Hello. We're gonna go look at a footprint out in the back of the,
Yeah.
What? Okay, now where was that footprint? It was right over here. There it is. Okay.
Looks like a shoe print is outlined in that 14. Sticky pool of something resembling chocolate. Footprint's about a size 14.
Oh no, I got ink all over my hand. Okay. Why did this pin... This isn't a very old pin. Why is it, like, doing that? Oh well, let's see. I still think it's an old pin. It might be. I hate it. You know when you pick up a pin and then like all the ink's kind of like collecting on the nib of it because it's retractable. It's all goopy and stuff.
Yeah.
That's what this pin's doing.
Well, you know that much about this person.
Yeah, well, okay. We got suspects. Oh. Get. Hold on.
What are you trying to do?
Go up the stairs. What?
What are you trying to do?
Why?
Up the stairs?
Okay, we have the size 14 shoe, so I could plug that into the information.
Well, I'm going to actually tell you just so you know and not worry about it too much, but you actually have to find all of those categories.
Ah, boo.
You have to find every one of those. Yeah, I know. It's not like what it is now where you can just type in a few things. Yeah, you have to find out every little category. You can even ask Rook now that you have explored a little bit.
Ooh, that's true. I haven't gone to see Rook. All right, Rook, tell me information.
So, Murphy, have you come up with anything yet?
Space pen?
Possibly.
I have a space pen, actually.
All business.
I've got some clues, but I need some more information from you.
Ask about... we already asked about these guys. The bracelet.
It was a beauty! Ah, encrusted with diamonds and rubies and inlaid with gold.
You know your jewelry, sir.
It makes me mad as hell that someone will break into the shop. I have a hard enough time making ends meet.
Crusade.
Don't get me started. That movement is nothing but a hate machine. The civil war's on the horizon because we mutants can't sit around and take the discrimination anymore. Those crusading fools have started something too big to control.
Okay.
I don't know anything about that.
Rusty?
I don't know anything about that.
Let's see. Do I have anything to share with them? Keys from the alley, maybe?
I think it would give you the option to show. So. Yeah, there's no show in the thing, yeah.
I think.
All right.
That looks like everything I have, so let's exit
to
the...
with prosthetics.
Exit to the street?
Yeah.
It's probably I think all the actors here have prosthetics. I don't like how he says meat. Okay. So, now what? How do I pass time here? Because I gotta wait till tomorrow before I can get a credit card to go into there. So... what now?
Well, you can go and ask the... go look around the clown shop.
Okay. All right, let's go look at Rusty's.
Yeah.
Let's see.
You need to beat the day.
It's all locked up. The only way I'm gonna get inside is by using my innate cleverness or ingenuity, or maybe a key.
Okay, well, I have a key, but that didn't seem to work. Unless... let's try again.
Well, that's not gonna work.
Okay.
It's all locked up. The only way I'm gonna... Rusty the Clown's novelty shop. Closed down a few months ago after Rusty...
Is there a rug?
Looks like a welcome mat. But when it's on the doorstep of a novelty shop, you can never be too careful.
Uh-oh.
I'm gonna move that.
I think you might have to get close enough.
It's all locked up. The only way I'm gonna get inside...
Yeah, we're... hold on. Aha! What's this? It's a key!
Whoa, a key.
Yeah, grab key.
There you go. Look at... examine that key.
We are going to oh my gosh. It's got a clown on it.
Wow.
Wow,
Rusty's
that is...
funhouse.
Yep, there's only one place that can go. We're going to use it on this door. And we're going to go... Oh, wow, it's... that's very red.
Oh. Gosh, that spooked me a little. Okay.
Why are there so many implements of... knives? On the wall. It's a joke shop. Why is he got the... is this a Knife Fight City clown? What is this?
No, we'll take a look around. We'll take a look.
We're going to look around, but I believe this clown knew what was coming, and it was Knife Fight City. He was preparing for the future. Look at these masks. They're just actual pictures of masks. That was just a mannequin had its wig. Oh my god.
Wow, the limited edition Daryl Hannah wig and mannequin set. I'll bet this is a real popular mask. Why, it's Mr. Sloppy Lasagna Eater.
Okay.
Oh, this is a scary mask.
Let's go.
Well, this must be Mr. Grimm. He's a reaper. Looks like my fourth grade teacher.
There you go.
Okay. All right.
Oh, there's another mask on the floor.
Whoa. Wait.
I have to admit it. Rusty had a fine selection of novelty items.
Including these.
These weapons are all made of plastic. All bark and no bite. Hmm. They're completely useless.
Okay, so maybe he wasn't preparing for the Knife Fight City future. Let's see. Nope. Space. Wig.
Whoa, this wig would even make someone like me look glamorous. This wig must be quite popular with shy people. A mask of the king? That's blasphemy! This wig probably sells well during the Bay Area Yodeling Festival.
They have a yodeling festival?
Mask on the ground.
See. I already looked at that one. Or is there another one?
You didn't click on it, did you?
I think I did.
Whoa! For a second there, never mind. I thought someone had decapitated Inspector Burns and left his head on the floor. What a great mask.
Scrap
oh, look,
that.
There's another item that you can take in the same spot.
I know,
have no idea
I
what I'd ever do
like
with a
mask.
Stacking ring, but what the heck.
All right. We need to give that
mask. Let's take
mask
a look at that mask.
Argo. We're going to. We're going to look at that mask, and I
well,
believe...
You can't give it to him.
I don't know. Let's take a look.
Because there's always an option to give people something, but I don't think there was one for this.
Well, wow. We didn't have it yet.
Okay.
But I feel like if we go to Ardo and be like, hey, look, masks, then he may be like, oh, hey, I'd like that. They might know something. What's this
yeah,
say?
Yeah, maybe.
That door leads out to the street.
I don't want to go there yet. Boxes.
Just a couple of empty old packing boxes.
Hmm. Yeah, you're going to have to walk over to it to be sure about that.
Yeah, it's okay. Haha.
Nope.
Oh.
Just a couple of empty old packing boxes.
Yeah, that seems to be the case. Okay. Let's see. There. Wait, what's this?
Oh.
What's that?
Cool. Plastic dart crossbow. It'll make a nice addition to my non-violent weapon collection.
That's an interesting collection.
Yeah. Sounds a little bit, doesn't it?
I guess so. Now, what's this right here?
Looks like some kind of in-house television.
Let's turn
Hi,
it
kids. It's me, Inspector Burns.
Oh, no.
And as we all know, fire can be our friend, but fire can be our foe. So many times, fire starts so carelessly. And what can fires do? Fires burn you. Never, never light matches. No, no, no. Fire is dangerous. Fire made me look like this. Do you want to look like me? No, no, no. Don't look like Inspector Burns. Don't play with matches.
Inspector Burns. I always thought he was a freak, but the kids love him. So does Ardo.
Well, now you do have a mask.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, Rusty was very fond of empty cardboard boxes.
Hey. I can move
Praise
this
Zorg,
one.
Indeed. Oh,
yes,
you're
Praise
have to go around
Zorg.
The corner there.
And all the burnings. Things. Okay, what's in that box? Oh, wait. What's this?
To Rusty Clown, life-size doll. Wow. It's a dead ringer for... Oh, no pun intended.
Grab it.
You have
that.
An inflated...
I can't get over how lifelike this doll is. If it didn't have a hook on the back and a battery compartment, I'd swear it was Rusty himself.
All right, it's got a battery compartment. And you have batteries.
We do have batteries.
I wonder
We're
if these still work. Tingly tongue. Still got juice.
Oh, come on.
Really? Really, Tex? Don't do that. Don't do that thing. That's not good for you.
No.
All right, now we have a working...
Oh, my God.
Oh, my. Okay. All right. That was most certainly a thing. Now, did I just move him closer so I can't... Can I not go back here? Oh, I can. Was there something on the floor? What's
no.
this? Is that just a... No, it's just texture. Okay.
Oh, there's a white thing on the wall
there,
too.
Yeah. What's this? Hello? What are you?
Maybe this key fits in that employees only door.
Such
okay.
a... inconspicuous place to put a key. Taped to the side of a pillar in plain sight. Oh, jeez, no. Stop it. I get stuck on the environment, and then it makes you spin around. okay. And ha! Okay. We got that, and we're going to use that on this employees-only door.
open.
I'm going to go inside. Let's go inside. The Rusty says, clean up your mess. Okay. Wait, enlargements. Enlargements.
Posters in here tell you more than you'd ever care to know about film processing.
Yes, that's what enlargements
okay.
mean.
Okay.
I was wondering what you were trying to go for.
No, I was just like, what is enlargements? What is this about? Darkroom stuff.
Posters in here tell you more than you'd ever care to know about film processing.
It's like the most basic sign for that.
So darkroom
stuff.
So,
enlargements.
Yeah, yeah. We got a darkroom sink. It's a, yeah.
A balloon strategically located near the water faucet. Looks like Rusty didn't go down without a fight.
Oh, okay.
The sink must have been used for developing photos. Not much use for it now since all the developing equipment's gone.
Okay, so Rusty was up to something or he had a photography business. Hello, what is this?
A plastic suction dart can be formidable ammo in the hands of an expert like myself.
Enlarge your guinea pig.
Yeah. Enlarge.
I mean, that's the thing. I don't know anything about film processing things, so I just see enlarge. I was like, what are they talking about enlarging?
Well, yeah, you gotta take that film negative and turn it into something.
I mean, that does make sense, the whole process. Well, it's behind the counter. It's a perfect place to hide keys. I know, Jake, but it was also taped to a pillar. It looked kind of obvious, but it's also a clown shop, so...
Warning, toxic acid.
Why in the world would Rusty keep a barrel of toxic acid?
I'll look under the sink in a second. We gotta open the barrel of acid first. This isn't going to end poorly at all. Oh, well, there he is. There's Rusty.
Oh, lordy. Well, this is where Rusty ended up. What a way to go. I'm willing to bet he didn't crawl in here on his own. Someone murdered him.
There
okay.
you go. Another clue.
Now, not to be a naysayer of things, but his skull, his shoes, that wig, those glasses, and that nose would have already dissolved.
You know what? Yes. You know what? You don't know. You don't know.
Yes, it could be acid-resistant wigs. You never know. This is the future of 27 years in the future. Why did he have a barrel of acid? You don't use acid in film development, do you?
It just reminds me of... Who Framed Roger Rabbit?
The paint thinner, yeah!
Yes.
Posters in here tell you more than you'd ever care to know about film process.
Okay, same thing. Yeah, yeah. It actually brings to mind, I remember watching, when I was a kid, watching the History Channel, you know, back when it was actually the History Channel, not just like aliens and stuff. And it was one of those, like, true crime, like, murder, here's this murder thing. And it was when the guy who, once he did the murder, he disposed of the bodies in barrels of acid. That gave me, like, I couldn't go to sleep after watching that. And since I was, like, 10, 9 or 10, I was just like, Mom, can I sleep in bed with you tonight? She's like, yeah. So... I went to bed. Yeah. I just remember just specific memory of that because of a barrel of acid with a clown in it.
Yeah, it's toxic acid, not strong acid. Oh, that's probably what it is then. Titanium reinforced clown accoutrements. Yeah.
The sink must have been used for developing photos. Not much use for it now since all the developing equipment's gone.
I can't look under the sink, sadly. But we know where Rusty is, so who do we take this information to?
Well, it's almost like Rusty and this case might be connected somehow.
How they're connected, I just don't know how. And we know it's going to have the crusade all over it.
Well, that's just this case.
True.
Oh, yeah, this is not the whole game, by the way. This case getting the bracelet, this is day one.
Oh, I know. But we also got Rusty. I feel like that's connected to something. It's all connected, guys. It's all connected. So, we know what happened to Rusty.
Well, why don't you go check and see if you can find the key to,
Okay, so we need to find the key to the Acme store. Where's that going to be at? Oh, the warehouse. So I think that's the only other locked place. Hold on. Let's go see Ardo, because we have the Inspector Burns mask.
Okay.
I feel like that just might be a thing. I don't know if it is.
The Golden Gate Hotel.
Be,
I heard that Ardo shuts the place down every once in a while to do fire safety upgrades. Maybe he's painting fire extinguishers in all the rooms.
So it's...
I heard that Ardo shuts
the... Okay, so it's... So we can't get it at the moment. We'll have to come back. Okay.
Well, he's doing fire and safety, fire safety inspections.
He is. But we can't go in to see if he wants an Inspector Burns mask.
Yes, but what
I
if...
I don't know
what if Inspector Burns went in there?
Oh.
Yeah, but you're not going to get away with just a mask. You're going to need something else.
We need the hat and everything. We're going to be able to get those. Ooh.
We'll check Rusty's house. Maybe he's still got stuff we just missed over.
Wait, in here?
Yeah, we didn't really...
We could keep
looking. I don't know.
I didn't really see much else, but we'll take a look. Is it going to do that every time we walk in?
I think it will. And it scared me again.
Wait. What is that?
Ooh, a small nozzle. Probably a helium dispenser used for filling balloons.
Oh.
Hey, we have a balloon.
You now have a helium-inflated balloon.
Yes, I do. Oh, I need to... This. Let's combine this with that.
Examine the ring, too.
I had a set of stacking rings just like this one when I was a little PI. Even has a small hole in it, just like the rings I had. Man, fill one of these with water and you can chuck it a mile.
Yeah.
Huh. Gotta go fill that up at the sink. But also, hold on. Do I... I feel like... we'll use that for something else. Okay. I don't think I need to put the mask on the dummy doll.
Well, that's not gonna work. The sink must have been used for developing photos.
So I'll have to fill it up. Whoa, somewhere else. Okay. I think that's it in here. Where can I get water to fill up that ring, though? Do I have a sink in my office? I don't think so. Fill it with acid? I think that'll just melt the ring. But you know what? It's worth a shot.
That is an option.
Well, that's not gonna work.
Is it just going to show the same thing? Yeah. Bloop. Bloop.
Oh, lordy. Well, this is...
Okay.
Yeah, we're not gonna get anything out of there, huh?
Nah, not the moment. Just decorations.
That was good. It's good. It's a good thing to look though.
I think. I think that's everything. For at least for now in here.
That door leads out to the street.
That's not going to wear get old at all.
No.
Nope. Not at all.
Not at all.
No, not at all. All right. Let's see. Now, just to get an idea, because we have new fax machine. It's probably going to be the electronic shop, so we got to get that first. I'm using the crime lab computer. Okay.
Well, let's go back and try the computer. Maybe we can just guess her.
Let's give it a hit. Let's give it.
We have a lot of evidence or a lot of description. We could probably at least nail out whoever this is.
Oh,
it's time to go into our office and become a PI.
We can narrow down the options here.
Mm-hmm.
Look, I can reach you from across the room. Ha ha. All right.
All right. We're in.
Crime.
It's like a UI nightmare. It is a little bit scotch.
Saved it. Okay, Caucasian male. Oh, that's good. It saved my stuff. Don't know about hair. Two eyes, green, AB. Shoe size, about a 14. Had tattoo of an anchor. Don't know any about that. Okay. That did not help at all.
No, I think it'll click over when you have the right one. So.
Crimelink computer is the only valuable piece of equipment left in the office.
Because Caucasian.
Are you sure the height is correct?
Yeah, because he said 6'3 or 6'4.
Okay. All right.
And he said about 300 pounds, which is in that range. The blood said no to mutant. I believe two eyes. They were green because she said eyes. AB negative. We saw a size 14 shoe. And a tattoo of an anchor.
That missing head. Yeah, I like that's an option.
Of course. So that's all we've got right now. So we do need more stuff, I guess. Okay. Well, what else can we do right now? Oh, hey, we're out of water.
Well, that's not gonna work.
Why is it empty?
This pure mountain spring water is indispensable, literally. I'm out of paper cups.
Oh, you know, we never asked.
What
we
never
asked the bum. We talked to him. We didn't ask him about anything. Burglary.
He's the one who told us he saw
that's
a suspicious
the door to
guy
the street.
Who was 6'3", 6'4".
Okay.
And 300 pounds.
I would say let's go check. I don't. Maybe I just had a brain thing. And I just totally.
That's okay.
It's at the beginning of the stream.
Let's walk backwards. Abandon safety and walk backwards.
That's a big
looking.
Do, Brian. Yeah, it is.
Let's go. Ooh. Ah. Mm. Oh dear. No.
There he is.
Hey, bum. I actually don't know your name.
Ask away. I saw someone prowling around the back of the pawn shop last night.
300 pounds.
So dark. Mm-hmm. I didn't get a good look at him, but I could tell he was huge. Probably 6'3 or 6'4, about 300 pounds.
Okay, so you want to... I don't think you picked 300, did you?
They didn't have 300, but they had a range of like 280 to 320.
Oh, okay.
So... Let me go talk to... Chelsea. I just want to call her Clarissa because of her outfit, but I know it's Chelsea. So she's got anything else. Maybe let's double check on the number of eyes. Whoa. Talk to me.
What can I do for you, Tex? Yeah, you know, I remember Rook told me about the burglary.
Green eyes, more
you
than
know,
one.
I remember a stranger hanging around the past couple of days. It might be a dead end, but I seem to remember that the guy had these bright green eyes and a tattoo of an anchor on his arm.
Try to combine what? Let's see.
Well, now that we have, we could probably just start guessing, considering that we have, like, the information we have is the information we've got. We should just go up there and just see.
Okay.
Yeah, why not?
We're going to do hypothesis. Hypotheses. Nope. Turn. No. Stop that. Tex. Stop that. Go the way I'm trying to direct you, please. I know I have very glidy tank treads, but come on, good sir. Come on. You have those dancing feet balance, use it.
Indeed.
Unfortunately, I have no, I couldn't combine the water ring with the acid, and I have nothing to put water in.
I see. 280, yeah, I see what you're doing. Okay. So we got that,
six,
we got that.
Four, mm-hmm. And they said he wasn't a mutant.
Just start picking random hair colors. No?
No, they said it was the norm, so two.
Try different hair colors. Because we don't know.
Have to try.
Yeah, we would have noticed any of those. You know what I mean? Like, it has to be a hair color we just don't have. Oh, there you go. That was
red.
It. Or I hope. Hopefully it's not somebody else. Oh, here it is.
Nick Flynn.
Okay. What's his rap sheet say?
642, Caucasian 300, Green, San Francisco, non-mutant, AB negative.
Oh, he Anchor just committed mail fraud right last October. It's 2020.
No, he did.
Yeah.
In how many days? Like 10 days he's going to do attempted extortion?
Yeah, in about 10 days he'll do attempted distortion, and then a few years petty theft, burglary.
2 years do petty theft.
Arson, attempted
like
fraud.
Men.
Grand Theft Speeder, importing illegal novelty items.
Novelty items.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And look, burglary, like.
He lives right here.
Juvenile. Oh no, he does, doesn't he?
Well, he's born here, I should say. I thought that was his address. All right, what's next?
The whereabouts of Mick Flynn are unknown at this time. The SFPD are interested in questioning him about the recent disappearance and suspected murder of Rusty Clown. It's likely that Flynn and Rusty were working together when Flynn was arrested for illegally importing Asian novelty items. Flynn may have murdered Rusty to get revenge on letting him take the fall. The theory has been supported by a street informant, Beak Nares, who claims to have seen Flynn within the past few weeks. Nares reports seeing Flynn in an extremely intoxicated state, apparently hallucinating, saying that Rusty Clown's ghost was out to get him.
Hmm. There he is.
That is,
That's a very 1980s man.
That is.
That mustache.
Hey,
that's
Seal.
Homegrown
that,
right there.
That hair, too.
Yeah, my uncle had glasses like those. I remember
majestic.
That.
Those glasses kind of look... My dad had glasses like that, too. That hair and mustache combo, man. Very late 80s, early 90s. I'm going to go see NASCAR down at the... with one of the many speedways. Well, we got a lead. Let's go see what people know about him. Let's go ask around. See what people can tell us about Mick Flynn. Mick Flynn, that is a name. Backwards with abandon. Okay.
That's
what's
70s.
Up, I check you first.
Yeah.
It's very, isn't it? Whoa. Wait. And freeze. Okay.
What can I do for you, Tex?
I want to ask about...
Oh, more. Down arrow below that.
Wait.
Down below. Yep, there it is.
Oh, okay. Mick Flynn.
Sorry. I haven't heard anything about that.
Beak Nares?
Oh, yeah. I know Beak. If you want to talk to him, you might try hanging out around Koi Tower.
I think that Beak was his informant, if I remember.
Okay.
Yeah, it was in his rap sheet.
We'll go to Koi here in a little bit. Let's go see what Louis knows about this guy. He might know some.
Yeah.
Louis!
Peak Florida man. Very dangerous, indeed.
Yeah, honestly, he's given those vibes, wasn't he?
Too bad you don't like fresh brains, mate. Hot off the grill.
Where are you getting those brains, Louis? Should I be concerned?
Don't ask.
Tell me about Mick. Do you know Mick?
Sorry, mate. Can't help you there.
Do you know Beak?
Sorry, mate. Can't help you there.
Okay, thank you. Who else might know? Well, Koi Tower. You know what? Okay, I want to stop by the Golden Gate, see if it's open yet, and then we're going to go back to the Koi Tower, because we got a name drop, so it might actually...
I heard that Ardo shuts the...
Never mind. Okay. Koi, are you available now? Let's go. Let's go!
I walk up the steps to Koi Tower and spot a small figure lurking in the shadows. In the half-light, I can see only the person's profile, but it's definitely Beak. As I walk towards him, he glances around, then approaches me warily, like a vegetarian sizing up a pot pie.
That's hilarious.
That's good.
Hi, Beak. Look at that walk.
What are you staring at?
Oh, that walk cycle's amazing, sir. All right, we're going to get down to business.
Yeah.
His prominent feature. I don't want to say anything about his prominent feature yet.
Why don't you? Are you afraid?
All right.
Pardon my staring, but that is a truly impressive schnoz you've got.
Come on. Don't make fun, huh? What do you want? Who are you?
Refer to Chelsea.
I'm a friend of Chelsea Bando. You told me I could probably find you nosing around up here.
Yeah, Chelsea, good egg, nice looker. So, what do you want?
So Beak's an elephant man. He's the elephant man.
Indeed.
I see what they did there. I see what they did there, the elephant man. Gotcha. We'll ask about that later. We're going to investigate first.
She said you might give me a lead on who robbed Rook's pawn shop.
Maybe yeah, maybe no. What you going to give me for the info?
Oh, what would he want?
What would he want?
A surgery gift certificate? Oh, that's messed up.
Maybe.
Okay, I can use this. My nose has started sagging lately. Makes it hard to breathe.
Oh.
Now, what kind of info are you looking for, huh?
That's a pretty good prosthetic nose. Even it's low res, but it looks pretty good.
That looks really good. I like it.
Tell me about yourself, Beak.
Oh, I'm nobody. I just try to keep my nose clean and my ear to the ground. Oh, wait a minute. Or was that vice versa?
No, that's correct. That's good.
Mick Flam's rap sheet would take a day to read. He's a fat scum. And he's an idiot to boot. That's why he's always getting caught. He's been busted for burglary, mail fraud, arson, you name it. Everyone knows he operates out of the Snow White warehouse. But don't tell him.
Okay, so Acme, the Acmes.
Yeah.
Tell me about Matt.
Anyone with a hunker like that can't be all bad. Malden's no rocket scientist. But I hear that he's not on the take. I've helped him out a couple of times, so he leaves me alone.
Okay.
Mail fraud. Yeah, exactly.
So he's not on the take. So I would say that he's at least a honest cop. He's honest cop, but...
Yeah. He's just not
no
nice.
No rocket scientist. Yeah, he's definitely not nice, but he's decent at his job. And
well,
at
me
least
and Naresar will
it.
Find out why when we beat Ooh. Sherlock. And we'll play the
that's
Mean
true,
Streets
that's
and Martian Memorandum as well, because he's not played those. So.
Mm-hmm.
Big trouble. It's causing mutant blood to boil, and I don't want to be around when the bullets start flying.
I don't blame you, sir.
Rook's pawn shop was robbed by a two-bit crook named Mick Flam. He and his girlfriend have knocked off half a dozen pawn shops over the past month. The girl goes to a pawn shop and hawks a bracelet for a decent amount of cash. Then Flam breaks into the pawn shop and steals the bracelet, along with anything else he finds.
Okay, all right.
The bracelet is the bait Mick Flam uses for the pawn shop robberies.
Tell me about Rusty Clown.
I think he's dead, and I'll bet Mick Flam had something to do with it. Word was the two of them were smuggling illegal novelty items from Hong Kong, and Rusty crossed Flam. Ever since Rusty disappeared, Flam has had a terrible fear of clowns. Bozophobia.
I don't think
that's
what that's
called,
but okay.
I saw Flam drunk, and he said he had nightmares of Rusty's ghost coming back to haunt him from the grave. He was completely terrified.
Interesting.
I know a little about him. Runs a pretty successful PI business.
Okay.
I can't help you there. He lets his wife run the pizza joint. I don't know what he does, though I've heard some things about who he does. You can tell he drinks a lot by that snoz of his.
Okay.
She runs that pizza place with her husband, Sal. I don't know much about her. A true Italian nose, though.
He knows a lot about noses. Well, hello!
I haven't got any info on that. Chelsea! Smart girl and a real looker to boot. She's got a cute little nose.
Okay.
I can't help you there.
All right, so we need to get into the Acme because that's where Mick is. All right, well, maybe... Oh, how we get in there, though? Let's go ask down at the pizza place about Mick. Maybe we can find out more, because it sounds like he doesn't go to Louie's, but... Whoa. Actually, you might know about him. Hey. Hey, chocolate syrup, man.
Ask away.
All right. Do you know about this man, Mick?
Wish I could help.
Do you know about Beak?
Nope. Don't know a thing about it.
Thank you very much, sir. I appreciate your time. But if he goes and gets drunk and he doesn't go to Louie's, because Louie would probably know him, then maybe he goes to the pizza place. At least that's my thought process here. Because it's a pizza bar.
What can I get for you, handsome? How about a big plate of linguine with my own special sauce?
Listen. See, this is exactly where I was thinking, and no thank you. I don't need that right now. I'm on case. We're gonna politely decline your big plate of linguine with your special sauce. Because, no. No thank you.
Sounds delicious, but what I really need is some information.
Smooth. Very smooth. I like that.
That was a good job, yeah. Tex. That's how you do. Tell me about Mick. Do you know Mick Flynn?
Can't help you, Tex.
Okay, never mind. Can you tell me about Beak?
Sorry, I don't know anything about that.
So he knows about everybody, but not a lot of people know about him. Yeah. Okay. Maybe, you know, let's talk to Rook. Maybe you can tell me more about just Flynn, because we got to figure out how to get in there. That seems to be, what am I doing? Nope.
You had a space bar when you want to stop, yeah.
There we go. Maybe that'll give me some more info, like, on his girlfriend, or how we can
What else can I help
there?
You with, Murphy?
Let's see. Do you know this man?
I don't know anything about that.
Do you know this man?
I don't know anything about that.
Let's go, then. Let's go to... Why'd I go to the alley? Let's go to our car and go see Mac. Because we have a suspect now, which
That's
means
true.
They. Yeah. Let's go do that. Okay.
The Bijou Theater.
All right. I'm not sure how to get to the warehouse from behind it.
That's true. We never did look.
True. We'll try that next.
Yeah, we're gonna take our speeder car.
Hello, Thunderclap.
Hey, how's it going?
Can't you find something better to do than bother me?
No, because I have... you know what? We're going to be apologetic.
I don't mean to bother you, but I'm still stuck on this case.
We're not stuck.
Sure
we have
you
a
are.
Suspect.
Probably a case of cheap scotch.
Tell you what. Deal. Help me solve this case I'm working on, and I'll buy you scotch. And not the cheap stuff.
Bribing a cop, babe, Murphy. Get out of here now, and I might not bust you.
I think you got what you needed from that guy.
He is honest, though. There we go. I appreciate that. Ooh. Let's go to... Here. Yeah, let's see what that does.
Okay.
Go to it. Is he going to do it? Please don't do the clown master. That is pretty cool, but look at slick.
No,
okay,
I don't like that.
No, we're just going to. Clowns don't even bother me, but that laugh, that I could do without the laugh. Let's flee. Okay, let's see. How do we get behind the here though?
Well, what's the door like? Is it like got a lock on it? Yeah, you're she's having trouble turning, if you guys are wondering.
It's very, very sensitive on the turns. It's open now.
Well, why didn't you open it before? Maybe we just
because
never hit open
it was,
on it?
No, it said it was locked.
Maybe. Now I'm starting to think...
If this is Mick Flem's hangout, he'll probably be back soon. I better try and set some sort of trap for him.
Oh, you better save the game, Mecha. Save the game.
How do we save? Can I save in a different file?
No. Yeah, you just at the top, you type a new file name.
Oh. And it won't override it?
No. Then you can add a comment to it.
Trap the Acme. Okay. Neat. What have we got in our inventory that we can use to trap? Let's see. We've got the life-size doll. The doll and the balloon. The ring toss ring.
Right.
Okay.
See, here's the thing. If you get busted, there you can't say that you're a detective. You have all this clown stuff in your inventory.
Yummy. A bottle of turnip schnapps. I'll bet it's got a real kick.
Turnip schnapps. All right, can we fill this up with that?
Well, that's not gonna work.
Let me fill up my ring toss ring
but
with
it's
turnip
it will
schnapps.
Be liquid.
Yeah, okay, sure.
But it'll still be a liquid.
Well, this is actually a storage compartment. Looks like it requires a special combination key. Locked.
I have this.
Well, that's not gonna work.
It was worth a shot. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Why don't you go... Oh, there's a barrel there.
We're gonna go... Yeah, what's this barrel?
Ooh... This barrel smells like it shouldn't be opened.
Then we won't open it. Let's go up these stairs. I feel like we could probably hang the... What's that say?
These large doors look like they haven't been opened since my last date.
Turnip schnapps, what madman created that? Yeah, it's real. It's a real thing.
At least in this universe it is.
No, for real. It's an actual real thing in real life.
Turnip schnapps is a real thing. Okay. Key! Wait. Okay. There's a key here.
This key must fit a lock around here somewhere.
Probably downstairs, so we're going to grab it. And then we're going to take this rusty doll, and we're going to put it on this hook.
The rusty doll looks great on the pulley hook, but I'll need to get it to move before it'll do me any good.
Oh, God. Oh, my
terrifying.
God, Mecha, no.
Terrifying. Okay, listen. Whoa, oh,
what's
no,
your, what's
no,
your, what is
no,
your plan
no,
here? Why do you have a gyrating no. clown up there?
No, stop running into the clown! We're going to, well, he's having nightmares as being haunted, quote-unquote, by the ghost of Rusty. Look what we've got, the ghost of Rusty in this life-size clown doll that dances. Why did the clown have these made? I don't know.
This must be the power box for the warehouse, and it's locked.
Well, you know what? We have the key from the warehouse, so we could probably use it on this. It looks like a door key, though.
Locked. The heavy footsteps I hear must be Flem. Luckily, my rusty trap's all set. I'll need to find a hiding place as close as possible to the pulley control box.
Where's
when
the pulley
Flem
control
least
box?
Expects it, I'll throw the pulley lever and bring Rusty back from the dead.
I think you have to crouch. Oh, shit.
Hopefully this isn't a self-destruct lever.
Hover over the lever itself. No.
Hopefully this isn't...
I guess this
don't
isn't
walk away.
The,
oh, God.
No. Nope. Okay.
You need
all
to
right,
get to the
well,
control... Okay, just hold...
I'm trying.
Hold your
okay.
horses.
Oh, hold on.
Oh, he's coming in. I just shot
him. Where am I? Is this a dream?
Okay.
Not quite, Murphy. You are dead.
Dead? Wow. Then you're the big PI in the sky?
That's right, Murphy. But now is not the time for you to be here. Your life must be restored so that you may fulfill a higher purpose. There is a vast and malignant evil at work on the earth, and fate, for some reason that even I cannot fathom, has chosen you to oppose it.
That is James Earl Jones.
It is.
I'm no more thrilled about it than you are. Nevertheless, your fate has been decided. I will do what I can to help you make your way, but only you can fulfill your destiny. Now, go back and try not to get yourself killed again. You will know when the time is at hand. Allow me to remind you of PI rule number 2. Hide from people carrying guns. Who do you think you are? Me?
That's fair.
All right. I like that.
That
I like
definite,
that. Let's see.
Yes, that is James Earl Jones, the voice of Darth Vader.
All right. We're going to try that again.
Yeah, Brofisticus. Hey, how's it going?
Okay, so where is the...
Well, you got
pulley controls.
Upstairs.
They're upstairs. Okay, so we just got to go upstairs and hide up there.
I think you were supposed to also check those crates, because you're just... Yeah, well, that's all right. You're,
oh, God. Oh, oh.
You're okay. You're okay.
Okay. So here we are. Just got to be very gentle. All right. And... Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Womp. Okay, I don't see the pulley controls up here, but we do need also.
I think
need to
the pulley
game.
Controls is downstairs.
Just that, I think it's that lever, but it wasn't letting me like.
Yeah, because you have to wait for him to come into the place, which means you have to hide.
The rusty doll looks great on the pulley hook.
I think that's
but
what
I'll
they
need
meant.
To get it to.
I think that's what he meant. Is that you need to hide first, so that means you have to get low, and you have to get behind a crate, but also check the crates too.
Okay.
She's trying to get down the stairs, but every time she turns the mouse, it spins a million miles an hour.
Oh, jeez. It does that. It really does that. That is... I'm not even touching the mouse right now. I'm just... All right. Now. Thank you.
Save
okay,
game.
Let's go ahead and... Yes, we're going to save right here. Okay. Trap is set.
Yeah.
Okay.
Give me one sec.
Now I know. Oh.
I wanted to take a look first.
Yeah. Because I think we should probably open that box. No, the
crate
box
smells like laundry soap. Crate in front on the floor seems to be partially opened.
We're probably going to crawl inside of that.
Well, try the one in front of it.
But I'm going to go
the
ahead
one
and...
the one in
no,
front of
wait.
It. Yeah, hover over the one in front of it. I saw there was another option.
Oh, hey.
Apparently some fireman dropped off his uniform to be cleaned and forgot to pick it up.
Well, we could probably hide in that. Well, I get the feeling that this guy was probably Inspector Burns. Now, we're going to...
Tax
open.
Collector.
Night owl.
That.
Hey, how's it going?
Oh, hello. With this.
Somehow this happened again. Thanks for the courtesy.
The footsteps I hear must be phlegm.
Okay.
Luckily, my rusty trap's all set.
All right, just, yeah, get inside the box. Then.
Okay. Oh, no. Okay. Get in the box. Get in the box.
Okay, nope, you can't get in the box. Yeah, uh-oh. you're overcorrected. Here, I got you. I'll get you.
Okay. Thank you.
Just, yep, there you go.
Okay. Cool. And then, huh? Oh,
hold on. There we go.
There. Okay.
I just wait.
Ooh. Okay.
Assuming he doesn't shoot you. Oh, wow. Look at this guy
nope.
walking in.
Oh, look at that. Look at that walk cycle.
It's great.
Okay. step. Ah, here's my keys and my... thing. Mmm, yes, rub
hands.
Ooh, it's me, Mommy's come back!
It's gone. Hey, Mecha, you did it.
Let's go get his keys. Wow, I... Oh my god.
Wow. Look at the hole in the wall.
Amazing. There's an amazing hole
Damn,
in the wall.
I'm good. This has to be Rook's bracelet.
But I meant like him look at
well,
it.
Well, I Damn, we're going I'm to. Good.
This.
We are going to do that.
Yeah.
Mick ran off without his keys. I'll bet at least one of these will come in handy.
I'm gonna take all of them.
No, I can't.
I can't. I can't look at the hole. Can I go through the hole? No, I
no.
can't. Okay. Let's go. Let's go give the bracelet back
well,
to
Well,
we'll
open that
very...
door behind you.
Hmm?
You picked up Where's those keys thing? For that oh. thing you never unlocked.
Oh, yeah. Hold on. And haha. Okay. Flynn's keys. Let's use that. Can I use these here? Duh. Haha. Ooh, box.
Ah, there we go. Ooh.
A lockbox within a lockbox. It must contain something worth having.
We've got the key from the alley.
I think you have to pick up the box.
Well, that's not going to work.
Probably.
Yeah, it's because it said get.
Maybe we combine it with...
Looks like it.
Ha ha! What do we have here?
What do we have here? Unless I miss my guess, this is jade. It's good quality, too.
That...
You have a big, giant, honking piece of jade.
I got a big piece of jade that doesn't look like jade because of the way... I mean, you can cut jade in a faceted way like this, but... The way that they kind of make it look almost translucent there means it's looking more like an emerald.
It's probably a really, it's probably a really high quality piece of jade.
That's, yeah, that's jade. Mm-hmm, that's jade.
You're trying to think. You know, well, the thing is, it's because of the overly sharp green color. You're thinking that it's translucent, but it's really not.
That door leads to the street.
Yeah, it does.
Let's go give it to Rook and take a look at that bracelet. Because we got his bracelet. Oh, front button. Forward!
I'm telling
Hello?
You, it's impossible. It can't be done. I've tried everything.
The prophecy
okay.
is very clear. We can't go on until prophecy. This step is completed. Surely your unique skills give you opportunity.
My ability has gotten us nowhere. Capricorn. Got there before me. They're always one step ahead of me. It's like they can read my mind.
We can't let them stop us. Maybe we can use your skills on someone else. I've made inquiries. And if he hasn't gotten himself killed, maybe he's just what we need. Murphy. Tex Murphy.
Nice.
Goose eggs and ham.
You did it. Day two. Oh,
we ended the day.
I feel better today than I've felt in a long time. Boy, did I stun Rook when I walked in and handed him that bracelet. Okay, so getting the bracelet back doesn't make me detective of the year, but it does stimulate the confidence glands. Maybe I can succeed at this business and turn my career around. But if I'm gonna do that, I better do something about my fax machine. Who knows how many new opportunities I've missed to show the world my greatness.
There you go. Let's save the game.
All right, we are going to save.
Despite being, I feel like I saw that guy a lot on TV in the 90s. It might have
fix
been.
Fix the facts.
Fix the facts.
We gotta fix the facts, guys.
All right. Well, that's the end of tonight's stream. Hope you guys enjoyed. We'll be back again on Wednesday with an MRE or two.
Ah, nice. Or two.
Maybe. Yeah.
Whoa.
What did you think of this game so far, Mecha?
Oh, this is delightful. The only thing, and I think it's more just me, is the movement control.
That's fair.
But no, dialogue is, mwah, it's beautiful. The FMV is classic and well done. Like, the prosthetics, even on a lower resolution like they had here, still, they look good.
Yeah.
They look like good prosthetics. They put effort into their costuming and design on these people, and I greatly appreciate that. But also, we got to hear James Earl Jones because we died.
Yeah.
So at least that's one benefit to us dying, is we get to hear James Earl Jones give us, like, a Sierra-esque, you need to do this next time, numbskull.
All right. Well, I'm glad that you enjoyed it. James Earl Jones is always a treat to have in a thing. If you can afford, he's a small-time actor, guys. So if you could just give him a call, you know, I'm sure he's looking for gigs right now. It's been a long time since he's did Under Killing Moon, so you know.
And Night Owl, you are correct. That is Blade Runner lady hair.
Yeah, that's exactly right. That's awesome.
That's exactly. What better than this noir, like, sci-fi detective game than sci-fi noir detective cyberpunk lady hair?
Sorry,
that was a ramble.
No, I was messing around on camera. Anyway, we'll be back again on Wednesday for the MRE stream. So until then, you guys take care. Have a good one. And thanks a lot for hanging out with us here on the Courtesy Flush. Let me see if I can close that out there. Anyway.
You guys have a good evening, everybody.
Take care, everyone. And see you around. Bye-bye.